So, after the previous year questions from rate measure, now I am going to discuss previous year questions from maxima and minima. This question is asked in JEE Main January 7, 2020 paper related to maxima and minima. Okay, you just have a look. The problem is related to maxima and minima along with the concept of polynomials. What is given in the problem? F of x is a polynomial of degree 5 which has critical points plus or minus 1 and limit extends to 0. Okay, you just look here. Limit extends to 0, 2 plus f of x by x cube is equals to 4. Then which one is incorrect? We need to judge these things. Okay, we need to find out the one which is incorrect. Okay, which is incorrect. Right, the problem is about finding maxima and minima of the function as well as functional values at 1 and minus 1. And in the same way, we need to check whether f of x is odd or not, like that. Okay, that in the sense, ultimately, our intention is to find what? The polynomial of degree 5. If you find that polynomial of degree 5, there is the problem. Right? You just try it. Just think about the problem. So, f of x is a polynomial of degree 5. Okay. First thing is the polynomial of degree 5. So degree of f of x is equals to 5. Since degree of f of x is equals to 5, so you just consider the polynomial as f of x is equals to ax power 5 plus bx power 4 plus cx cube plus, okay, dx square plus ex plus f, maybe a fifth degree polynomial, right? See, which has critical points plus or minus 1, then this statement, which has critical points plus or minus 1, will generate that f dash of 1 is equals to 0 and that is equals to f dash of minus 1. F dash of 1 is 0, f dash of minus 1 is 0, because we know that critical points exist at f dash x is equals to 0. Since as given, critical points are plus or minus 1, f dash of 1 is equals to 0, f dash of minus 1 is also 0. And the third condition, see, step by step we need to read out the problem and we have to solve. Limit extends to 0, 2 plus f of x by x cube is equals to 4. Okay, pay attention here. See, 2 is a constant. Limits won't affect constant values. So you just send 2 to the other side. So this is nothing but limit extends to 0 f of x by x cube is equals to 2. Because if you send this to that side, it becomes 4 minus 2. Right? I have these three restrictions in my hand. Using these three, I need to find out the polynomial f of x. After finding the polynomial, I need to check which of the following given options are correct and which are incorrect. Okay. So I will start my solving with this particular last condition. What it is? Limit extends to 0, f of x by x cube is 2. Okay. Limit extends to f of x by x cube is 2. If your f of x is this complete polynomial, when you divide this complete polynomial with x cube, you left with f by x cube, e by x square, like that. As x is tending to 0, that f by x cube term will tend to infinity. Right? And so, see, these three terms are to be neglected for the given polynomial function. What I am saying is, I think you all good at limits. From limits, one thing is very clear. Limit extends to 0, polynomial by polynomial value is a fixed constant only if those two polynomials are of same degree, or otherwise it tends to infinity. Okay, you just have a look. When you divide, see, not of same degree, okay, this is not extends to infinity, right? Okay, this is just limit extends to 0. Okay, so what I am going to tell you is, if you consider this total polynomial in the place of f of x, and since you are dividing with x cube, if you divide dx square with this x cube, you left with d by x. That d by x is a term tending to infinity, but it is given a constant, right? And that's why dx square is not a suitable term for this f of x according to this condition. Not only dx square, ex and f also not suitable. Okay, because when you divide these three terms with x cube as extending to 0, they tend to infinity, but it is given constant. So with that analysis, what I am going to conclude is, from this condition, d is equals to e is equals to f is equals to 0. Okay, d is equals to e is equals to f is equals to 0, and then we need to divide this ax power 5 plus bx cube plus cx cube with x cube. And if you divide these three with x cube, if you divide these three, ax power 5 plus bx power 4 plus cx cube with x cube, now what will happen? Okay, see, there is a chance to write directly, but for explanation I am giving here, limit extends to 0. Now I have only these three terms by neglecting the other three, and we are dividing with x cube. We have ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 2. F of x by x cube is this ax square plus bx plus c as limit extending into 0. When you replace x with 0, what will happen? This term will become 0, this is 0, and automatically you will get c as 2. So by using this limit extends to 0, f of x by x cube as 2, we have def as 0s and c is equals to 2. Def as 0s and c is equals to 2. Okay, right. So now, after this, my f of x is, therefore, f of x is equals to ax power 5 plus bx power 4 plus 2x square is f of x now. Still there is a problem to solve to find this a and b using this f dash of 1 is equals to 0 and f dash of minus 1 is equals to 0. Now what to say about f dash of x? You just try to write f dash of x now. Ax power 5, right? So 5ax power 4 plus 4b x cube plus 4x. 5a x power 4 plus 4b x cube plus 4x is f dash of x. Now use this condition from critical points. Okay. So what it is now? Now f dash of 1 is 0. This is f dash of x. Replace x with 1. You will get 5a plus 4b plus 4 is equals to 0. Replacing x with 1. Similarly, replace x with minus 1. Now what will happen? 5a minus 4b minus 4 is equals to 0. So from there we need to get the value of a. So if you add, what will happen? These two gets cancelled, these two gets cancelled. Okay, just have a look. F of minus 1, so from there we will get what? 10a is equals to 0. And if a is equals to 0, that is not a polynomial of degree 5. Is there any mistake in the solution? Just have a look. Okay. This is not 2x square, right? C is 2. So this is 2x cube. Since it is 2x cube, then this is not 4x, 3x square. And so this is 6x square. Now if you replace x with 1, 5a plus 4b plus 6 is equals to 0. And when you replace x with minus 1, 5a minus 4b and this is x plus 6 is equals to 0. Okay. Now if you add 10a plus 12 is equals to 0 and the value of a is minus 12 by 10 and that in the sense minus 6 by 5. A is minus 6 by 5. Use that a value to find b. After finding a and b, we need to check all the remaining things. Okay. Yeah, a is equals to minus 6 by 5. What you say about b? Replace a here, okay? 5a is equals to minus 6. Use minus 6 here. Minus 6 plus 6 gets cancelled, okay? You left with b, then b is equals to 0. So a is minus 6 by 5, b 0, and then c value is 2. So at the end, what is our f of x? Therefore, f of x is simply nothing but minus 6 by 5. X power 5, b is 0, leave it, plus 2x cube. This is f of x. Actually, it is given as a fifth degree polynomial, so it contains all these six terms. So, from this limit concept, one thing is very clear that def are zeros as well as c is 2. And using these critical point conditions, easily you will find that b as 0 and a is minus 6 by 5. So, at the end, this is f of x. Now, when you observe this, since it contains x power 5 and x cube, clearly f of x is an odd function. And now from this you just calculate f of 1 minus 4 into f of minus 1, whether it is 4 or not. our target is to find the incorrect value, so you just choose all the correct things first. Okay, if you try to calculate all the correct things, what will happen? This is f of x, f of 1 minus 4 of f of minus 1. I am just checking this first of all. F of 1 is minus 6 by 5 plus 2 is f of 1. What is f of minus 1? Minus 4 of f of minus 1. Minus 1, and then this is 6 by 5. Minus 1, so minus 2. You just try to calculate whether it is 4 or not. So how to calculate? Minus 4 into 6, minus 24, minus 6, minus 30, minus 30 by 5 is minus 6. And then this is what? 8 plus 2, 10. 10 minus 6 is 4. So this is also a correct statement. So B is correct, D is correct. Now we need to check A and C. For sure among these two, one is correct and one is wrong. Actually, without checking these two also, one may easily identify that. See, since these two are critical points, for sure, at these points we have maximum and minimum. So, either A or C, if you observe these two, any one of these two is correct and one is incorrect. So, with a blind guess, one of these two, A or C, is incorrect one among these four. No need to check this D and B also. Okay. Now, where we have maximum, where we have minimum. Don't go with all other work, you just calculate f of 1 and f of minus 1. If you calculate f of 1, what is value? At 1 and minus 1, we have maximum minimum. Okay, what I am going to tell you is f of 1 is equals to, replacing x with 1, 2 minus 6 by 5. And if you calculate, that is equals to 10 minus 6, 4 by 5 is f of 1. And what you say f of minus 1? So f of minus 1 is 6 by 5 minus 2. And if you calculate, you will get minus 4 by 5. That in turn represents that 4 by 5 is a greater value, minus 4 by 5 is a minimum value. So at 1 we have maxima, at minus 1 we have minima. So this is also correct option, this is wrong one. And since the question is about identifying incorrect, option C is your answer for the problem. All this we need to solve in mains examination. So since this is a question from mains, you need to solve this problem in a time of 2.5 minutes. Okay, and better if you solve it in a 1.5 minute. Okay, so whether it is possible to solve in that particular 1.5 minute or 2 minutes time? Yes, if you are aware of all the concepts which we are using in this problem, then it is very easy to solve the problem in that time. Okay, see, using this limit concept, limit x tends to 0, f of x by x cube is equals to 2. From there, identifying D, E, F and C values, that is the main part. Okay, if you identify these values easily, then the remaining part of the problem is somewhat simple. Okay, have a look.